Philippine regulators moved to block access to Chinese crypto giant Binance over unauthorized activities in the country. A Tuesday notice by the Securities and Exchange Commission said Binance has not been cleared to sell or offer securities in the Philippines. It said it will request a ban on the use of the platform from relevant government agencies. The move is expected to take effect in 3 months to give Filipino investors time to withdraw their investments. Recruiters and dealers of Binance engaging in the practice were also warned of jail time or a fine of up to 5 million pesos. Binance, in a statement, says it's committed to complying with local regulations. It also says it has undertaken measures to address the SEC's concerns. The embattled crypto exchange is facing a probe in the U.S. over alleged violations of a slew of securities laws.
The last missing Filipino in Israel, Norlin Babadilla, is now safe after being held hostage by Hamas militants for 53 days. Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Eduardo de Vega says she's currently undergoing medical evaluation. He adds Babadilla, who is a dual citizen of Israel and the Philippines, has yet to say if she wishes to return to the country. De Vega also received assurance from the Israeli envoy to Manila that Babadilla will receive financial benefits from Tel Aviv. With this development, all Filipinos affected by the war have been accounted for. Before Babadilla, another Filipino, Jimmy Pacheco, was released from Hamas captivity.
There were people entertaining the thought that she might have been among those who were killed on October 7th. In fact, the Israelis were conducting DNA tests on some of the bodies which have not yet been identified. So when we learned from the Qatari government yesterday, hours before the actual release or transfer, that she was alive and was included among those to be released, of course, we were overjoyed because this indicated, you never lose hope. Yeah. Miracles happen. Uh-huh. And that our diplomatic representations and our balanced foreign policy are actually bearing fruit for the benefit of our kababayans.
The Philippine government is not keen on lifting the terror tag on communist rebels. National Security Advisor Eduardo Anio says it will stay until a final peace deal is reached. His statement comes after the National Democratic Front issued several demands before formally returning to the peace table, which included the removal of its terrorist tag. Anio says the government has learned its lesson in talking peace with the NDF. The National Security Advisor adds security operations against communist insurgents will continue, even as both sides agreed to restart peace talks.
The Philippine government working on a framework to enable the resumption of peace talks with the National Democratic Front. Carlito Galvez Jr., presidential advisor for the peace process, says they've yet to receive the formal report from the delegation that struck the deal in Norway. He adds consultations for the framework will involve various stakeholders. Galvez declined to say when the formal peace talks will resume, but he lauded the NDF's openness to finding a peaceful resolution to the decades-long insurgency.
Technology company Smartmatic has been disqualified from all procurement processes of the Philippine election body. But COMELEC clarified the decision has nothing to do with a petition to investigate Smartmatic's hand in alleged irregularities in the 2022 national elections. COMELEC Chairman George Garcia says they have to maintain the integrity of the country's electoral process. He adds the decision is immediately executory unless restrained. Smartmatic expressed disappointment over COMELEC's decision. The company says it has consistently adhered to all the poll body's procurement processes during biddings and contract executions. Smartmatic has been the Philippines' tech provider for automated elections since 2010. Philippine Senator Ronald De La Rosa shares he's happy after talking about the International Criminal Court with President Marcos. De La Rosa and other senators met with the President and First Lady for a casual dinner on Tuesday night. De La Rosa says he privately discussed the ICC issue with the President during their dinner meeting. But a senator insists the details of their talk will remain confidential. De La Rosa was the chief instigator of the Duterte administration's drug war, which is currently being probed by the ICC.
Two House committees unanimously vote to adopt resolutions urging the Philippine government to cooperate with the International Criminal Court's probe into the Duterte administration's war on drugs. The House Committees on Justice and Human Rights deliberated for more than 4 hours. The resolutions focus on the Philippines' cooperation with the ICC and not on the country's return to the organization. The panels also agreed to coordinate the resolution with a similar one that was filed at the Senate. This so Congress can adopt as a whole a concurrent resolution. Concurrent resolutions do not require the president's signature and do not have the force of the law. The ICC is investigating the anti-illegal narcotics campaign of former President Rodrigo Duterte after various incidents of extrajudicial killings.
In other news, the Philippine Health Department allays fears about the reported increase in respiratory illnesses in China. Health Secretary Ted Herbosa insists they are closely monitoring the situation overseas. He adds there have been no reports of any rise in respiratory illnesses in the country as of the moment. The DOH nonetheless urged the public, especially children and the elderly, to take precautions and apply layers of protection.
We can activate immediately the same way we activated during COVID-19. Sir, so huwag mag-alala mga kababayan natin sa mga news reports on respiratory illness in China. The advice is to the people, you know, okay. Cough etiquette, stay at home. Our hospitals are now ready after okay. Our experience with COVID-19.